Good afternoon, St. Agnes. Welcome to the Liturgy of the Holy Spirit. Today we gather to formally bless our academic year. Though this year is very different than we have known before, it is full of new and different opportunities. As we begin this year, encouraged to stay curious and explore these new opportunities, let us not allow the circumstances of this time to get in the way of our personal growth, our relationships, our openness to new experiences, and our connection to God. Staying curious is an important part of our faith and a reminder for us to keep asking questions and learning new things. Being a part of St. Agnes means we are sisters, each inspiring all. We are a community that leans on each other in times of need. We urge you to continue to be Academy women that help build up our community and make the world a better place. Today we will invite the Holy Spirit to be with each of us and to guide us as we journey through our lives and discover more about ourselves.
Even though we are not in Meyer Hall today, we are united in our prayer and our participation. As the Word of God is proclaimed today, we invite you to listen deeply to the message contained in the Scriptures. What speaks to you? Is there a word or phrase that is particularly meaningful? As part of our prayer, there will be a time to share in your advisory, thoughts about the readings, and hopes for the year. We invite you to put away anything that will distract you from fully engaging in today's prayer. Know that we gather as an extended community today with parents, alums, and friends of St. Agnes, joining us and praying with us. We are grateful to Father Phil from St. Teresa in Memorial Park for being a part of our celebration today. Let us take a few moments to center ourselves as we begin our prayer.
Holy Spirit, you are welcome here. Come flood this place and fill the atmosphere. Your glory, God, is what our hearts long for, to be
Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Let us pray. Gracious and loving God, from whom every gift comes, send your Spirit into our lives with the power of a mighty wind. With the flames of your wisdom, open our minds, that we may remain hopeful and curious about the promise and possibility this year brings. Protect and affirm the gifts you have given us. May we preach the good news by our lives and be witnesses of your truth and love. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Let us now invite the Holy Spirit to open our minds and our hearts to listen attentively to what the Spirit is speaking to our community and to each of us through the Word of God. As you listen to these readings, try to pick out words or phrases that stick out to you and that relate to your life.
Reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Do not fear, I am with you. Do not be anxious, I am your God. I will strengthen you, I will help you. I will uphold you with my victorious right hand. When you pass through waters, I shall be with you. Through rivers, you shall not be swept away. When you walk through fire, you shall not be burned, nor will flames consume you. For I, the Lord, am your God, the Holy One of Israel, your Savior. I give Egypt as ransom for you, Ethiopia and Seba in exchange for you. For you are precious in my eyes, and honored, and because I love you. The word of the Lord.
God is our refuge. God is our refuge and our strength. God is our refuge and our strength, and ever present help in distress. Thus we do not fear our earth mistaken, and mountains quake to the depths of the sea. Though its waters rage in foam and mountains totter at its bosom. God is our refuge and our strength.
streams of the river find the city of God, the holy dwelling of the Most High. God is in its roots. It shall not be shaken. God will help it as it breaks its way. The nations rage and the kingdoms totter. He utters his voice and the earth melts. God is our refuge and our strength.
The Lord of hosts is with us. Our stronghold is the God of Jacob. Come and see the work of the Lord, who has done fearsome deeds on earth. He stops wars to the ends of the earth, breaks the bow, splinters the steel, and burns the field with fire. God is our refuge and our strength.
Be still and know that I am God. I am exalted among the nations, exalted on the earth. The Lord of hosts is with us. Our stronghold is the God of Jacob.
A reading from the letter of Paul to the Ephesians. Brothers and sisters, I urge you to live in a manner worthy of the call you have received, with all humility and gentleness, with patience, bearing with one another through love, striving to preserve the unity of the Spirit through the bond of peace. One body and one spirit, as you were also called to the one hope of your call, one Lord, one faith, one baptism, one God and Father of all, who is over all and through all and in all. The word of the Lord.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel. According to John. On the evening of that first day of the week, when the doors were locked where the disciples were for fear of the Jews, Jesus came and stood in their midst and said to them, "Peace be with you." When he had said this, he showed them his hands and his side. The disciples rejoiced when they saw the Lord. He said to them, "Peace be with you. As the Father has sent me, so I send you." And when he had said this, he breathed on them and said to them, "Receive the Holy Spirit." The Gospel of the Lord. God's word is living and effective. Speaks to each of our hearts in unique ways. I wonder, what is the Lord saying to you as you hear these words? What might these readings hold for you? We've asked some of your classmates to share their thoughts, and we would invite you to think about how these readings relate to your life as well. As we now take time to hear how God's word has spoken to the hearts of the following women, I invite you to reflect and listen for the still small voice of God speaking to your heart.
In the reading from Isaiah, the lines, "Do not be anxious, I am your God. I will strengthen you, I will help you," really stand out to me. To me, this is God telling us that what is happening in the world is a new experience for everyone, but that when we are able to stop being anxious and just accept His plan, God will guide us through this experience, and this experience will make us stronger.
In the reading from the Ephesians, it says one body and one spirit, which really stuck out to me. To me, it is a reminder that we are a community. We belong to the same body and the same spirit in Christ. We all have a purpose, so each person is essential. Our body cannot function correctly with a missing part, so it is our job to take care of each other and make sure our body and spirit are complete.
In Psalm 46, it says, "He utters his voice and the earth melts." To me, this verse is capturing how all-powerful and mighty God really is, and how he could destroy the earth just as easily as he created it. The fact that we are still here now means that he still has a purpose and a plan for us, and wants us to fulfill his mission of love and peace on earth.
Something that really stuck out to me about John's gospel is how Jesus told the disciples to receive the Holy Spirit, and the way Jesus sends them out into the world.
I think what holds us back from true connection with God and others is oftentimes ourselves, and we have to consciously let God in so he can work in our lives.
And a reading from Isaiah 41, "Do not fear, I am with you," stands out to me. To me, this is saying that with all of the hardship that we have faced this year, it's been hard to remember at times the one who is watching over us. But with this scripture, it is a reminder that God is here and he is watching over us.
What are these readings saying to you? What sticks out to you? Is there a message that relates to your life from these readings? We invite you to pause the video to reflect on the readings we've just heard and to share any reflections with your advisory. Advisors can share the PDF of the readings if you'd like to look at the readings as you reflect and share. When you are done discussing, return to the liturgy where you left off.
Good afternoon. I hope that each of you were able to hear a message from the Lord in these readings. As you know, as we begin each year, we ask the Holy Spirit to be with us throughout the year and to bless and animate our community. I don't know about you, my friends, but this year I find myself fervently praying for the Holy Spirit. It seems we need the Holy Spirit more today than ever. And because we need the Holy Spirit more than ever, a few things stood out to me in these readings. I wonder if they stood out to you as well. Did anyone notice in the first reading, the Lord said to Isaiah, "Do not fear. I am with you. Do not be anxious. I am your God. I will strengthen you. I will help you. No matter what happens, I am with you because you are precious in my eyes and honored, and because I love you." Yes, our God loves each and every one of you. You are precious in God's eyes and honored, and you are loved. My dear Academy woman, I wonder how many of us need to hear that today and really let it sink in. Our community is made up of nearly 950 incredible students. Each of you is unlike any other. We have athletes and scholars and musicians and actresses and so many combinations therein. We have families who have lived in Houston for generations and families who have just moved here from cities all over the United States and the world. Each one of you brings your own story and life experiences into our community, and that makes our community better, stronger, and more creative. We can learn from so many different perspectives. Do not give in to the temptation to blend in. You are precious and honored and loved. And this is true for all people. As Catholics, we believe that every human is created in the image and likeness of God and is loved with an everlasting love. We believe that every life is sacred for the entirety of life. It is our duty to defend each precious person in every way we can, standing up against injustice and working so that all people are given an opportunity to live life to the fullest. This is our call. This is our responsibility. We need each of you living confidently, working to make our world the best place it can be. This is what St. Paul reminds us in his letter to the Ephesians. We are united as one community in the Lord. It is up to us to care for one another and build one another up. We all know this is difficult because our world right now is so divided. My friends, we are in an election year, and there is pressure for us to choose sides and villainize the side that is different from our own. Listen to me carefully. We cannot do that. We will not do that. We must never post or say anything mean-spirited or degrading. We will not tolerate it. Amen? I want to hear it. Amen. As Dominicans, we are consensus seekers. We are listeners. We are women who study and who ask the hard questions. Our school-wide theme this year is going to be essential. Stay curious. When someone says something or posts something we disagree with, rather than becoming defensive, we must listen, ask good questions, challenge ourselves and others to learn from perspectives that are different from our own. As St. Paul says, we must live with humility and gentleness, with patience, bearing with one another through love. Stay curious and seek to understand. This is complicated, of course, because we have been socially distanced since March. Try as we may to connect, we are spending a lot of time virtually looking at one another in these little boxes. After Jesus' resurrection, the disciples found themselves cut off from others too. They locked themselves in the upper room. They were afraid and they were uncertain as to what to do next. And that is when Jesus appeared to them saying, "Peace be with you." Jesus even repeated himself, "Peace be with you." My friends, allow yourself to receive the peace of Christ in these uncertain times. Trust that Jesus is with us, that God is our refuge and our strength. Jesus then sent his disciples into the world, breathing on them and saying, "Receive the Holy Spirit." My friends, Jesus says the same to us. Receive the Holy Spirit. And the Lord sends us forth. How will you go forth this school year? What is the Lord asking of you? What is being asked of our St. Agnes Academy community? How will we carry forward the commissioning of Christ to be God's presence in our world? I am counting on each of you to be positive and a beacon of hope for each other and for our community. Can I count on you? I know I can, because you are Academy women. And my dear Academy women, we need the Holy Spirit to guide us now more than ever. I do not know what this year has in store, but I do know that God is with us. And I pray that the Holy Spirit will enlighten us and give us eyes to see, ears to hear, and hands to do the work of God, feet to walk the path of justice, and mouths to preach the good news. May the angel of paradise watch over us and lead us at last to the reign of God. Amen. God bless you.
Just as the disciples received the Holy Spirit, we ask the Holy Spirit to send upon this community of St. Agnes. We pray for the gifts of the Holy Spirit and offer the following intentions.
Send forth your spirit of fortitude and understanding, Lord, that we might prevail in working for justice and looking out for those marginalized in our world, especially those who are continually impacted by the sin of racism and persistent violence. When so much in our world seems divisive, be a strong presence within our community that invites curiosity and longing to unify amidst such division. For fortitude and understanding, we pray. Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, send us your spirit of wonder and awe, that we may embrace an awareness of creation, seeing the many good things you have gifted to us in creation, and working to protect our earth in the gratitude for all that you have given us. May we always be aware of the beauty of others and God's image reflected in humanity. For wonder and awe, we pray. Lord, hear our prayer.
Spirit of wisdom, continue to bless our Holy Father, Pope Francis, as he guides our church in creating a world of peace. For wisdom, we pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. Spirit of wisdom, as our St. Agnes community continues to navigate transition and unpredictability, give us insight and creativity to continue growing and learning. For wisdom, we pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer.
Spirit of fortitude, give us the strength to persevere amid the many trials in our world today. Give us patience and resilience during this ongoing pandemic. Bless those who are affected by Hurricane Laura and those who are also affected by the Western wildfires. For fortitude, we pray. Lord, hear our prayer. Spirit of courage, we ask for your blessing and strength to speak out against injustice and speak up in love to create a world that upholds the dignity of each individual. Give us the courage to stand with those who are marginalized by racism, sexism, prejudice, poverty, and all that divides, so that we courageously create a world that reflects the kingdom of heaven. For courage we pray. Lord, hear our prayer.
Spirit of knowledge, reveal yourself to us in scripture and help us to stay close to your word, that we might always know God's love, mercy, and justice. For knowledge we pray. Lord, hear our prayer. Spirit of counsel and right judgment, guide our world leaders and each of us as individual leaders in making good decisions. May we know right from wrong and live in the light and truth of God. May we discover God's gifts in ourselves and seek to affirm the gifts we see in others. For counsel and right judgment, we pray. Lord, hear our prayer.
Spirit of courage, ascend upon each student, faculty, and staff member within the SAA community. Help each member of our community to embrace our uniqueness as the people God made us to be, living authentically, and encouraging one another to be the best version of ourselves. For courage, we pray. Lord, hear our prayer. Spirit of understanding, help us to discern God's plan for each of us and to trust in God's providence, especially when we do not see the road ahead fully. For understanding, we pray. Lord, hear our prayers.
Eternal Spirit, embrace all those who have died and welcome them into the kingdom of heaven. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer.
We join together our thoughts and our prayers. Together we say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done.
We would like to take a moment to welcome our newest Academy women, our ninth grade students. You are our new sisters, and we welcome you. We bless you in a special way today as you join our Dominican community. You join the ranks of many generations of women, dedicating themselves to the Dominican pillars of prayer, study, community, and preaching. As a tradition of St. Agnes, every incoming student receives a Bible, the Word of God, which will guide your life in the four pillars. You will receive your Bibles in theology class. We know that you will be women of the Word and will always carry your Bible in one hand and the news in the other. In a moment, Father Phil will bless the Bibles which you will receive. Though we are apart, we are together in prayer and united in community. So I ask that everyone gathered lift our hearts and minds as Father Phil leads us in blessing.
Again, I pray, please bow your heads as we pray. Creator God, Redeemer Christ, and Spirit of Truth, we ask your blessing upon these Bibles, an important gift and resource for these new Academy women, the class of 2024. May these Bibles draw those who read your word closer to you in love. Help those who receive these Bibles to be courageous, confident women of veritas, working to bring your truth into our world. Help each one of them to know how much she is valued and how important she is to our community. With your grace, help the class of 24 to praise you, to bless you, and to preach your word of love every day. Amen.
We also want to take this opportunity to ask God's blessing on our new principal, Ms. Carlene Ringley. Many of you already know her. She is an Academy woman, class of 2000. She has taught English, history, served as department chair, associate dean of students, academic dean, and now she is our principal. She is a member of the Dominican family and a parishioner at St. Catherine of Siena Catholic Church. We are grateful for Ms. Raymond's leadership, and we ask the Holy Spirit to bless her as she begins this new role in our community.
Ms. Raymond, you have assumed the role of principal of this great community, St. Agnes Academy. Your leadership of this school is a response to your baptismal call to be a servant leader, a preacher, and a minister. And so I ask, with God's help, that you accept this role. Creator God, source of all knowledge and wisdom, you sent your Son to live among us and to proclaim his message with faith, hope, and love. In your goodness, send the power of your Spirit over this reign as she begins her tenure as principal. Strengthen her with your gifts, that she may lead with courage, integrity, and compassion. Guide her every step as her leadership inspires the Tenacious community to manifest more deeply the Dominican pillars of prayer, study, community, and preaching. As she lead and teach by word and example the truth that comes from you. To you be glory and honor, now and forever. Amen.
I want to take a moment to thank all of you for celebrating with us and wish you all a very restful, wonderful, long weekend. One thing that stood out to me during the liturgy was from the Gospel, when Jesus appeared to the apostles and said, "Peace be with you, receive the Holy Spirit." And that's my hope for you this school year. First, that you will receive the peace that God offers and then go out into the world strengthened by the Holy Spirit. This year will be unlike any other, and who knows what God has in store for us. With God's peace and the gifts of the Holy Spirit, this will be a great year. Thank you, Father Phil, for celebrating with us. Thank you, Dr. Jervy, our coordinator of liturgy, Mr. Smythe, our coordinator of campus ministry, and Ms. Slutt, our director of campus ministry. I want to recognize the incredible creativity and leadership of our Dominican preaching team. Have a great weekend, and we'll see you soon.
Lean on me when you're not strong, and I'll be your friend. I'll help you carry on, for it won't be long till I'm gonna need somebody to lead.